Students, let me tell you about the copies. First is you will make two copies in science, one as homework, another one as classwork copy. So homework copy should be small size, single line copy, and classwork copy should be small size practical copy. So you will make two copies, one as classwork, another one as homework. Let us start with the exercise of circulatory system. First the objective ones. In human blood, hemoglobin is found in option C, RBCs. Pulmonary vein carries option A, oxygenated blood. Next, let us come to the third one, that is function of platelets is to help in clotting of blood. The blood is red in color due to presence of option A, hemoglobin. Blood vessels that carry pure and oxygenated blood are called arteries. Nucleus is absent in RBCs. The only artery which carries deoxygenated blood is called pulmonary artery. Now let us move to the next page, true or false. That is subpart D, right? True or false. Plasma is a part of blood. True. White blood cells are also called erythrocytes. False. Capillaries are the thinnest blood vessels. True. Human heart has four chambers. True. Now the fill in the blanks which are given. Answers are written over here. So let us begin. First, fill in the blanks. First one. The oxygen-rich blood from the lungs comes to the dash of the heart, that is left auricle. Second, the dash artery takes the blood from ventricles to the lungs. Answer is pulmonary artery. The liquid part of coagulated blood is known as serum. The instrument used to find out the blood pressure is known as sphygmomanometer. The color of a red blood cell is due to hemoglobin. The two lower chambers of the heart are called ventricles. The blood plasma contains a dissolved substance called hemoglobin. So now let us start with the question answers. Subpart C, question answers. Okay. So first question is, what is plasma? Write its constituents. So answer is, blood plasma is a yellowish liquid component of blood. It contains digested food, gases, proteins and waste products. I repeat the answer. Question number one, what is plasma? So blood plasma is a yellowish liquid component of blood. Now second part of this question is, write its constituents. So it contains digested food, gases, proteins and waste products. Second question, name the main artery which takes the blood to different parts of the body. Answer is aorta. Question number 3. Why are WBCs called soldiers of the body? WBCs, they are called soldiers of the body because they defend our body against infections. Okay. So, white blood cells defend our body against infections. So, we call WBC as the soldiers of the body. Next question is, give any three differences between an artery and vein. So this answer 4, students, you will get on page number 4 of that chapter. And also you can refer to the previous video. In that clearly I have given the differences between artery and vein. Now next question number 5. State any 5 functions of the blood. So 5 functions of the blood. It is clearly given on page number 3. But you can refer to the previous video to know the 5 functions of the blood. Now move to question number 6. Question number 6 is, what is the rate of heartbeat in a normal human adult person? So it is 72 times per minute. Next question is, why is color of blood red? It is due to hemoglobin. Next question number 8. In the human heart, blood circulates twice for making one full round through the body. Explain briefly this statement. So this answer is given on page number 5. Page number 5. You turn to page number 5 of your books and the answer is here. That is, in human beings, circulation of blood through heart occurs twice. First, deoxygenated blood from right side of heart enters into lungs for oxygenation. Secondly, oxygenated blood from left side of heart is sent to different body parts. Because of this reason, circulation of blood is called as double circulation. Now move to the next question. That is question number 9. Question number 9. Differentiate between the pulmonary circulation and systemic circulation. So the answer is here pulmonary circulation. Okay. Circulation of blood from heart. Which chamber of heart? Right ventricle. To lungs and back to heart. Which chamber? Left auricle is called pulmonary circulation. And what is systemic circulation? Circulation of blood from heart, which chamber, that is left ventricle, to body parts and back to heart in right auricle is called as systemic circulation. Okay, so this is answer number 9. Now move to the next question, that is question number 10. Why is it necessary to know the blood groups of the donor as well as recipient? So answer number 10 here. To prevent coagulation of blood. That is, to prevent coagulation of blood, we should know the blood groups of the donor as well as the recipient. Now next question is, red blood cells have no nucleus. Then why do we call them cells? Actually the answer to it is, why RBCs do not have nucleus. That is, they do not have nucleus to increase the surface area, or you can give the answer as, the RBCs do not have nucleus to contain more hemoglobin. Next question is, name the three kinds of blood vessels found in human beings. With the help of suitable diagrams, differentiate between them. So answer number 11 is, three types of blood vessels are arteries, veins, capillaries. The diagram of these three are given on page number 3 of the chapter. And the difference between arteries, veins, capillaries, you can refer to the previous video to get the answer. Now question number 12 is, state briefly the difference between the white blood cells and the red blood cells. So that difference between RBCs and WBCs also I have explained clearly in the first video of this chapter. Okay students, so this way we complete the first chapter, that is the circulatory system.